not too kind.
Can I get an encore?
So with Jay-Z, right, he got a couple lyrics that say different things, and it kind of intertwines with your story a little bit in the sense of Jay-Z talks about grand opening, grand closing, yeah. Right? So your grand opening, you were the CACC Rookie of the Year, and now in your senior season, you're the Player of the Year, right? Yeah. So talk a little bit about your experience from your rookie season in 2019 to now and being named the Player of the Year.
So from rookie year, like my first year here, it was a big like change from high school to college, on and off the field. Just thank all the seniors and the upperclassmen that took me under their wing right away. And I basically did what they did with the underclassmen now. So I appreciate y'all.
Basically, leadership was passed on and passed along, right? So as a senior now, being named the 2023 CACC Baseball Player of the Year, how much of it do you put on your shoulders? How much of it is attributed to your team and kind of the culture that you guys were able to form?
I give it all to my team. They helped me get through times where it was rough, slumps and everything. They kept pushing me through everything. So I thank my team too.
Another Jay-Z lyric is men lie, women lie, but numbers don't. You have 17 home runs, which is tied for second all time in the CACC. 60 RBIs, that's tied for fourth overall. On-base percentage is tied for first at 549. And your .885 slugging percentage is the best the conference has ever seen, right? So how were you able to put up such impressive numbers, you feel, this year?
This year, I just didn't worry about the numbers. I just went out there and had fun. It's my last year competing at this level, so I was like, you know what? I'm gonna leave it all out there and just have fun. We might have a game Friday and a game Saturday. We lose Friday, we're gonna bounce back Saturday even better. Come out there and perform way better than what we did the day before. You know what I mean? Like, it's nice to have like individual goals, but I wanted a team goal and I wanted to win it all, so yeah.
Bloomfield here challenges you to kind of write your own story by coming here and being shaped for success. How do you feel the college, Bloomfield College, has prepared you for the next chapter in your life?
It broke me out of my shell. Like, throughout high school and like middle school and stuff like that, I was always like the shy kid. Like, I didn't talk too much. Like, a lot of people knew me, but I just didn't really talk that much. Here, it made me like really get out there and start exploring new things, what I like and what I wouldn't like. So I thank the college for that. Yes.
In your life, who would you say is some of the most influential people that kind of helped you to get to where you are today?
My mom, my dad, and Waddy, Jeff Watson. Jeff Watson mainly because he gave me a chance that no one else really gave me out of high school. So yeah, thanks, Waddy. Yeah, so he gave me an offer out of high school, the only offer I got, and I took that and ran with it basically. And it helped me become the man I am today.